Hello, everybody. Before this episode starts, I would like to mention that this episode was originally filmed on a set. This set, to be exact. And during the recording, I had to go off and do something, and my computer died. So I thought, hey, it's probably not as effective to do it on the set where I don't really have any access to plugs here. So if I ever mention a set or a location change, just know that it was originally filmed here. So without further ado, enjoy the episode. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Ty Talks. I'm your host, Ty, and today on the very first episode, I'm going to be talking to my good friend, Ronnie, a.k.a. Rondog248. How you doing this grand evening here, Ronnie?
Let me just tell you, Ty, I am doing fantastic.
You love to hear you truly do.
It's lovely to be on Ty Talks, talking to Ty.
Yo.
Ty, as I call him.
That's freaking crazy. So,
he's kind of a big boy, though. He's a good man.
That's what they say. So, okay. So the first, how this show is going to work here is I got like a set of like six questions that I'm just going to be asking every guest here. So you're going to be the first. Mm-hmm. This is the big experiment here. Then I'm going to branch off into some like, individualized questions and then capping it off with another base one.
Okay, cool.
Rock and roll. All right, so, and my phone just turned off right when I was about to ask. So, first off, just like, what's your shtick? What do you do?
Anything. I don't make videos. Henry, our good friend, our mutual little appliance, he always tells me to do stuff. But what I want to do, and I am actually working on stuff, is I'm going to make sort of season 3 style Thomas videos that are like sort of set within that aesthetic and just how those episodes felt. But I want to do... It's like I want to really hit a broad audience, but I do Bachman stuff. So like H-O-O-O. I used to do Wooden Railway. Maybe someday I'll take a swing at it, but right now I'm really into the Bachman stuff, so that's what I'm doing.
Yeah, like
I also do music, I guess.
All of which, if you ask me here, they're all quite grand, quite nice sounding.
Hi, I'm gonna give you a big sloppy kiss.
Yo, dude, I'm blushing right now. If you're looking on a little camcorder here, I'm blushing right here. Okay, so what is, like, I guess your favorite thing that you're doing in the fandom here?
I think one of my favorite things, I like, for the fandom at large, you mean, or, like, just what I do?
I mean, either, really. I mean, probably the latter, but, like both can be good, I guess.
I think my favorite thing within my sphere that I'm not saying, like, I'm super talented, but I like to, like, combine my love of filmmaking and my love of music. And just in general, how I would like the characters to feel and like storytelling. I like combining all of those things into like one huge hobby that I do. And it's one of those things where it's a hobby that I can only really do on the internet. Like, I can't go to like a club and do it. I'm sure there's clubs out there for other people. I'm not trying to knock that sort of thing, but I don't really have one where I live. So it's one of those things where it's a very singular hobby, but it's one of my favorite things to do is just come home and even just think about video ideas or just workshop like a Thomas theme or just make a song. It's really fun to do stuff with these characters as well. They feel really... I was thinking about this last night. I got home at 3:00 last night. I don't know. I was hanging with my friend. And I was just sitting in bed and I was thinking like the Thomas universe inherently... Like, it's a kid's show made for children, but if you think about the episodes on their own, there's nothing that, like, explicitly says it's, like, a preschool show. It is just a storyline, and they just have funny colors, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do. I mean that's honestly, like, that's one of the best ways to, like, look at it. Like, it's kind of a universe that anyone could really, you know, dip their toes in and find something interesting in.
Yeah, there's always, there's something for everybody within it. Like, it's a very inherently kiddie show with a very... because the characters, they act like children. Like, because I was arguing and stuff. Yeah. But you can find a lot of stuff to like about it. And, hey, there's a lot of adults that act like that as well. But I think my favorite thing about what I do for, like, the community is that I haven't done too much in, like, the wider scheme. But I've done like collab crossovers with some Wooden Roy people in the past that were really fun. They're all pretty good dudes. They do their own stuff still, I think. And yeah. I've done like music for other people as well, which is always really fun to do. I think that's my favorite thing is doing music for people. Like, I don't really like filming collab stuff. I don't hate it, but like, I don't know. It's kind of weird just for me. But I really like doing music for people because I can kind of stretch how I make themes for people, unless they want a specific thing. But I like to kind of branch out and do different topics. I think it always works out pretty well.
The last couple of videos that I've had have had some of your themes in it, and I really enjoyed like incorporating it into my stuff. Like for like I teased in my little update video, like it was the bear story, and you made the bear theme for it, which I think sounds magnifico.
Yeah, they would say. And when I make my own custom like Thomas themes or even the songs in general, there are always gonna be like motifs that I reuse like later on. Remember when I was in my high school band, we had this one song, and I can't remember what it's called for the life of me now. But I incorporated one of the motifs from it into the famous Eights by the Farm soundtrack. I also incorporated like a Mega Man song in there.
Oh yeah.
It's like you can't really tell, but like I mean I can tell because I knew what it was. But like if you didn't know any better, you'd be like, oh, it's just some orchestral music. But I like doing that as well. Like when I get the chance to incorporate stuff that isn't Thomas inherently into music or even into stories, that's always fun.
Like it's always fun. Like if I'm hopping in call someday, like you're just cooking up a fresh little tune, I'm like, hell yeah, this is what you like to see. You love to hear it.
Yeah, it's always fun. Cause then, especially with like the music stuff, like in calls or whenever I do the music making streams, but it usually feels like it's a big group, like not a project, but like an experience where we're all kind of just listening in and hearing how things sound and kind of workshopping it all together, which is always a really fun. I think that's my favorite thing about the community, is not just like the singular aspect of it, but like when people work together on stuff and they take all of their best talents and put them together, I think that's when the community really shines the most.
Oh yeah.
And that's just me, of course, but.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. Like, it's like whenever there's like a big collaborative effort, like most of the time it turns out pretty, like, it goes from like a B minus to like a solid A plus plus.
Yeah, and even if it's not like it's a super excellent thing, I think the fact that there's multiple people working on it immediately makes it a higher, not like a higher effort, but it gives it like a higher sheen of quality than just like a standard thing, which doesn't mean the standard thing is bad. But I think that's where the community shines the most, is when tons of people come together and make something that is greater than the sum of its parts.
Oh, yeah, no, like, it's always great when somebody, like, there's a project going on, and, you know, somebody has multiple people kind of with the same vision. You know, like, I always like when people, you know, just kind of do that collab-y sort of stuff that, like, that turns out kind of exactly how they wanted it. Like, that's always a great thing to say, I think.
Yeah. I don't know if I've derailed this conversation, but...
No. Trust me, this is exactly what I kind of wanted to show. Kind of going off into different tangents, you know? It's fun.
Yeah, I love derailing conversations. Oh,
it's the best.
I have water.
It's okay,
though. I grabbed the water. I knew it was coming up. All right.
Well, man. All right, so speaking of which, let's hop on to the next question here. So, what is the first sort of Thomas thing that you remember enjoying? Like if you go as far back in your memory as you can, like, what's the first Thomas
thing? As far back
as
I can remember. I know, so the way I was introduced to Thomas was, I think I was 3, and my grandpa had like this like big wood table, and he had nailed wooden railway tracks to it. And it was just Thomas and like James. And this was back when they had just redesigned them. So Thomas didn't have his stripes or whatever.
Oh, yeah, like 2000.
James was the redesigned one, but Thomas still didn't have the red stripes on top. It was like the learning curve. I don't know how you would describe it. I guess the 2003 models or 2002.
Yeah, it's like early 2000, early 2000s model.
Era.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was that era. And that's definitely what got me hooked. But I think the first like episode I remember like in my head visually seeing, I remember I went to a day out with Thomas, and I think I saw like Trust Thomas on a TV, but I know Trust Thomas must have been one of the first ones, because it's one I can always clearly like remember watching a lot. So that's probably the one I think might have been either my first or the one I can remember the most.
Actually, fun fact, sort of related. But the first, like, memory of YouTube that I remember is, like, my dad was showing me, you know, YouTube back in 2008, maybe. And the first ever thumbnail that I saw was, like, that the really old, like, RSGCMA upload of Buzz Buzz. Like, it was like the close-up thing of, like, James's angry face. Like, that was the first thing that I remember seeing on YouTube ever.
Yeah. No, the YouTube, back when I was growing up, YouTube was, like, it was, like, the Wild West. Like, so much crazy stuff on there. Especially when you're, like, a little kid and you're looking up Thomas videos. Back then, the Thomas parodies were, like, re-uploads of, like, British, like, skit shows.
And Family Guy, for some reason. Like, I specifically remember a bunch of, like, Tony Family Guy skits things.
Well, there was Cousin Stewie, a classic.
you love it.
But I remember, there's a lot of Thomas episodes that I never saw, like, officially. But I remember watching remakes of, like, I remember one time I got home and I had, like, this, like, they had bought me, like, the DVD for A Big Day for Thomas. And I'd never seen the Flying Kipper before, like, in the actual episode. Right. And I was like, I finally get to watch it, because I'd seen remakes of it.
Yeah.
And even back then, I didn't know, like, the Railway series. Like, I knew it existed, but, like, I didn't know how far they got, right? So I figured, like, okay, the Thomas the Tank Engine book, that's definitely the Railway series. I had that one. But I didn't know, like, James Goes Buzz Buzz. Budgery story that seemed like such like a season three, like they wrote it for the season story.
I'm thinking about it, like I always like forget that's a Railway Series story until I look at like the like complete Audrey thing for like remakes and stuff that I do. Like I always forget, but like I always stumble on the first page of that for some reason.
Yeah, no, it's so weird. It feels like such like a Britt Allcroft David Mitten story, but in a good way though. I love those stories.
Yeah,
people be hating on season three, but I think it's actually a full banger season.
Yeah, no, I wholeheartedly agree there. I mean, there's some, like, I don't want to say duds, but they're, like, you know, not like, on the same level. It's more of a slice-of-life situation. And I do enjoy those. I mean, to be fair, I'll always, like, be going back to, like, Escape for the most part. But, like, if I'm watching, like, the full season through, I will never skip on those episodes.
Yeah.
We're hopping on to question three here. What is your favorite all-around Thomas thing? Like, this like could be a book, story, ever? Season. Yeah, like anything.
Oh, that's so hard. Hold on. I think probably, I think I'd probably just said it. Like, season three is my favorite season. I guess that would count. I don't know.
I mean, it could be a piece of merchandise, too.
Figure out. Yeah, a piece of merchandise. Oh, shoot. I don't know. That's so tough. Let me think about it. One of my favorite pieces of merchandise was probably that 2002 Thomas without the stripes, like the just recently.
Yeah,
I remember
classic.
I got like a super fresh one from like a train. This is where I'm at. This is where it is. And it was really good to have that just because that's the one that resonates with me the most. Like I like the Mattel one and I even like the 2010 Thomas or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't really like the 90s Thomases. They didn't win really. I'm not a huge fan of them.
I mean, before like 96, I think that's when it kind of pops off. That's why I like 92 to 96. That's why I like it. Like I don't like that weird like the one when they just introduced the plastic funnel. I don't really like those ones.
Yeah, I don't know. It's weird. I like the redesigned engines a lot because that's the era I grew up in. I think that a lot of them, but like face wise, you could be a preference thing, but. Design-wise, I think almost all of them are better than their original counterparts.
Oh, for sure. Definitely.
But, like, show-wise, definitely season 3. CGI era, I heavily fuck with 19 and 21. I like 20 a lot,
yeah.
But, like, 19 and 21 have a lot of, like, very good stories in them. And I think people sleep on them a lot.
Yeah, no. I mean, we've had a lot of conversations, like, kind of based off of that. But, like, I wholeheartedly agree. I love season... Like, more season 19. But, like, a good chunk of the stories from 21, but like 19 is where I really resonate. Like that's when I think.
Yeah, 19.
That's when it visually.
19
peaked.
Is a lot like 3, kind of. It's very slice of lifey. There's no like super life changing moments in it, which is good. I think they don't need to have like a season full of like epic reveals and like crazy shit just to make it enjoyable. I think you can have like a bunch of fun little stories that are very self contained and still enjoy them.
Yeah, I mean, like...
That's what I want to do. Like, I don't want to have, like, super, like, oh, holy crap, a new engine comes and the Sodor poop factory explodes. I want to be, like, in my videos, I want to make stories that are just very down to basic earth. And simple. But that doesn't mean I don't want to like not tackle like the sort of bigger stories. Like right now I'm working on Out of Puff, which means eventually I would like to do the rest of the stories from that book. And there's nothing super life changing in it. That's like a very slice of life book. Yeah. But it does have some cool moments in it. Like I think the one where he gets a brick like thrown at him. That's pretty funny. That's a story.
That's pretty funny.
Or whatever. Yeah, I don't. It's the James one. It's the James one that isn't the Kipper one. That's gonna be.
Oh yeah. Oh, is it Cross Lines? Is that it? I don't remember.
No, that's a different one.
This?
I think that's a different book.
I don't know. Those ones always like they all kind of like blend together for me sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. That Clark Cross Lines could be anywhere that wasn't like Jock or Wilbur, and you would be like, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, it fits perfectly. Yeah. All right. Question four here. This is a topic that we've talked about a shit ton, but what is a dream Thomas prop that you would want to own?
Oh, that's such a good one. That's a discussion that it changes like depending on like what I'm thinking about.
No, it changes like the wind for me.
The one prop. So there's two of them really that I know are like dead set in my head. Prop number one would be like the season four Rusty. Like I know what's his name has it.
Yeah.
But like, cause my dad's favorite character is Rusty, so that'd be a really cool one to have for him and for me to like enjoy. That's why I really want to do a Rusty prop replica someday.
That'd be sick.
I'm gonna learn it because I know that would make him very happy.
I know.
Or large scale Duncan, because large scale Duncan prop is fucking awesome.
Like no, I dude, just him. Go to Japan, break into Hara, snatch that little guy, and get out.
Another prop. There's a lot of props that would be really cool to own. I think, like any of the Jameses, maybe not Worf James, but like James, yeah. like a prop of James would be really fun to own. He's a really good design.
Yeah, no, like
I think
like,
Henry would be a really cool one if it was like classic era colors with like the gloss. Is that they all have to have gloss coat. You can't do the stupid, disgusting matte coat. I'm gonna make that the hottest take in this podcast. Matte coat sucks.
All my homies hate matte coat.
Smells like poop.
It does, dude. If I could sniff, like fucking Gordon or something.
I'm trying to think of props. Oh, the diesel prop, definitely.
Oh, I saw the diesel prop, dude. It was like an out of body experience.
Out of diesel experience.
Dude, I was, dude. If I had my little like a Dremel like cutting tool, I'd be like, zzzz, and snatch the little boy. Take him away.
A fun prop to own that is not like a thing you would like to like, look at this Thomas prop, just like the Duke painting. That'd be like a fun way.
The thing is like, I don't know like with those ones like I don't know if they've survived at all. Like Sean has office, like that's a cool place.
I don't know if they survived
place.
Or if like even what how big they are. That's a thing. Like it might be like a decent size. I made like a little replica one that I painted like 3 years ago.
That'd be fun.
Okay. Yeah, no, I might redo it because. I could always do better, but like, I don't know. That'd be one you could like hang on your like mantelpiece, big. Yep, and like no one would even care. They probably wouldn't even see it.
Like, that's a weird choo-choo. You like Thomas the Train? That's weird. Like, I don't know.
That'd be really cool.
I mean, I've always been like you said, the diesel prop. But I've for a good minute here, I've always been dead set on the Cranky prop. Like, I really like Cranky. Cranky's a really fun guy to have.
Yeah, Cranky's a really good character. He's one of those guys that fits right in no matter where you put him.
Yeah, no, like if he was like plucked from a Railway Series, I wouldn't bat an eye if I didn't know.
He's definitely like, yeah, he's definitely Audrey based in how they wrote him. He's a good guy.
So I mean, he was the first like new non-Audrey character, right?
Pretty sure, yeah.
I mean, there might have been some from season 3, but like I'm not sure though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's cool though. He's a good
cool guy. It's kind of harkening back to what we were talking about earlier. What's your favorite piece of merchandise? That's probably gonna be the Thomas again though. I don't know.
Yeah, probably the Thomas. But let me think. Oh shoot. I think recently, like if I was to pick something, like because that's like an older piece of merchandise. If I had to pick something recent. Probably, let me think. I'm going to probably say that Cool Props LBSC Thomas is a really cool concept. I would love to see them do more props, but like what if versions of it?
LNER Gordon. That with. Like Gordon James.
LNER Gordon, I could maybe see them doing. I think Black James would be a fun one for them. Ooh. That's like a big one. Like, that's probably already in the works.
I wouldn't be surprised if that was, like, for the 76.
I just think it's really cool to have, like, replica of the Model Thomas in colors that happened in a later era that was not model. I think that's really, really cool.
Oh, yeah, no, I shat my fucking britches when I saw that for the first time.
Like, and the way people were reacting, I think, proves that that's such, like, an excellent risk that, like, needs to be taken more, is, like, putting spins on classic and making it feel like it's from that era. Like, the LBSC Thomas does feel like it came out of season one.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
It's like a model era thing enough where you're like,
I can see that.
What? It makes your brain think for a second. It's really cool. I love.
You know, I had to register Ben for a sec. I really want the Bill. I want the Bill and Ben more than, like, the actual Thomas in my life for me. Like, I love me some Bill and Ben action. I mean, really anything from. Whoa! I just had an idea. Yo! Okay. What if.
Alright.
What if, like, for the next cool props thing, it was the large scale Duncan?
Okay, I would probably shit myself and definitely pre-order it.
Dude, I mean, that, I mean, that's
going in the Rondog bank.
I mean, it's at Hara, I mean, I don't know, buddy. I think
at some point they could definitely do the narrow gauge engines, like, either like a subline or just keep them in the same line. But, like, that definitely seems possible.
Yeah, no, I would have a fucking field day with that dude. Like, I want Peter Sam.
Peter Sam, the large scale engines, like, besides their faces, their models are pretty good.
No, they're solid, like, A's.
It's really the faces that people get.
I can see that.
Like, and even the colors, I can understand, but, like, the model work of them, like, Duncan, I think, is their best looking one.
Oh, for sure.
I think maybe Peter Sam and, like, Reneas are seconds.
Mm.
I think they all look pretty good.
I really, I like Fisher Handel, too. I mean, I know that was in, like, season 5 stuff, but, like, I like the Fisher Handel a lot.
Yeah, their channel's pretty decent.
Mm.
I think it'd be cool if they did more, Bachmann engines. Like, there's a lot of repaints they can do, and people hate the repaints, but LBSC Thomas and Busy B. James and the Blackwell James, those are all cool. I think even Busy B. James is funny as shit.
No, I do. Busy B. James is hilarious.
I think, honestly, they could do a chocolate crunch Percy, and, like, that would probably sell pretty decently well.
Oh, God, dude. Surprised
they haven't done that yet. It's usually Thomas and, like, James that have gotten repaints. I'm surprised they have not done a Percy one yet.
You know, I mean, Percy, like, he has enough, like, potential for those. Like he's been in enough sticky situations.
Yeah. You could probably repaint freaking Henry Blue and just make that a 75th item or, like, a 80th item, whatever's coming up.
Whatever you do.
Yeah. I think Bachmann stuff is probably my favorite merchandise range coming out in this millennia. Just because that's what I use for videos, but also because people give them a lot of shit, but I think that, at least with their engines, like, recently their products have been pretty good. Like, yeah. Rosie looked pretty cool. I'm excited for Daisy. The narrow gauge engines are nice.
I can't wait to see, like, Daisy and Peter Sam. Like, that's gonna be really fun, I think. I want to see how they really do.
To have to complete the branch lines.
Oh my god, dude! Daisy. The branch line fleet, yum yum yum.
I think with Daisy being announced, though, if we're thinking about it in, like, the CGI era, I think Ryan's gotta be coming up.
Oh my god, dude. Oh, I didn't even think about that, dude. I love Ryan.
Like, we're thinking about it, like, they're gonna complete the classic era characters, and that's probably a good thing, right?
Mm.
But, like, when you think about it, I think it's more likely that they're just saying, like, how do we get out the characters that have been in, like, the past several seasons? Daisy's probably been in the pocket for a while, so I think Ryan's coming. I would hope so, anyway. I think Ryan would be really... I'd like him more than Stepney. I could do Stepney anytime, really.
You know, Stepney, like, there's enough, like... If you get, like, the old Hornby ones. Terriers. Yeah, no, the old Hornby ones, like, that, like, that's classic series enough, I think. But, like, there's not, like, any, like, lower detail.
And there's people making kits and stuff, but, like, Ryan's a tough one.
Yeah.
I think Ryan would be a really cool one to see.
Yeah, that'd be really fun.
But, yeah, I think, merchandising-wise, Bachmann's probably my favorite. To make a long story short...
Bachmann's great. I like me some Bachmann every once in a while.
Tomy's pretty cool too, but I don't really have too much Tomy.
That's a whole other can of worms.
Yeah.
All right, now hopping on to the last question before the individual boys. So what are some, like, outside of Thomas things that they're really fucking with? Like, what's, like, you know, what do you like? So what else besides funny trains?
There's a lot of stuff that I like that is besides the funny trains. I'm a really big Sonic fan. I like Mario stuff too, but I'm a really big Sonic guy, and that's usually what I'm doing when I'm not doing Thomas stuff, is I'm playing a Sonic game, or I'm just, like, making music recreations for Sonic stuff, or I'm just even, like, thinking about it. I think I'm going to do a channel eventually where I do video essays on the classic Sonic games on Genesis and maybe beyond, because I really want to do a big video on Sonic 2, because I love that game. I also, like, collect Transformers to an extent. Haven't been doing it recently, but I know they're coming that I'm going to have to pre-order, because they look sick as shit. But I want to get, like, at least a classic, like, 80s cast sort of going. I've got a couple of, like, the reissues from the 80s that are nice. I paint, like, landscapes and stuff. I like doing that a lot. I go to my friend's house a lot. That's where I was yesterday. We make rap music in his shed. He built a shed. It's got, like, soundproofing in there, and it's freezing cold, but it's fun, though. Like, that's less like I'm making serious music and more like we go in there and we rap about poop and it's really funny and we laugh a lot.
I mean that's really the meaning of life, isn't it? Like, rap about poop, have a great-ass time.
Yeah, and I mean, I want to do a lot of stuff, like, this year particularly. I always say I'm going to do a lot of stuff. But this year I'm gonna try to get into cooking because I just want to learn how to cook and, like, food for people.
It's great. I've been doing that, like, a lot in the past couple months. It's really fun.
Yeah, no, I think it'd be tons of fun.
Like, I'm legitimately thinking about doing a cooking video kind of soon, like making like roasted potatoes and shit.
That'd be a new concept. That'd be cool.
Like, I have a Thomas cooking channel. Like, you don't see that at all.
That'd be interesting. But, like. Yeah, I do a lot of shit posting, and I just kind of sit around and think a lot. That's kind of it.
They call you the philosopher.
They call me the philosopher because all I do is sit there and think, like, all right, so what if I made this joke, but I replaced this word with poop?
A lot of the time they're bangers, so you know you love to see
a lot of the time they are bangers.
They're great.
But one thing I really want to do in the future, like, of, like, YouTube or with whatever, is I want to direct some sort of, like, horror movie where I can use miniatures in it to an extent.
Ooh.
Like a sci-fi sort of horror thing. So I feel like that'd be really fun to do art design for. Maybe that'll be this year, like, over the summer or something. Who knows?
Ooh, like, it'll be a little Halloween thing. Like,
yeah, that's just the, that's the long-term plan. But for now, I will just make the funny train models. Someday I'll crap out a video and then we'll all laugh and cheer.
It'll be great. Now hop it on to
some... It'll be great.
Yeah, you'll love to, and you'll enjoy to see it sometimes, I think.
Yeah. Oh, I also play Mega Man. Mega Man's fun.
Mega Man.
Rock, paper, scissory. But, like, once you learn the weapon pattern, it just becomes a game of, like, just learning or just knowing where to go immediately and just trying to, like, get it done as quick as possible.
Oh, yeah. Like, I honestly do. I want to see you, like speedrun Mega Man. That'd be fun.
Yeah, no, it's fun. It's not like I'm very good at it. I'm not good at speedrunning games, but it's just fun to do it.
Yeah. And now, we're hopping on to some individualized questions here. So out of, like, all of your music, like, what was your favorite piece that you've done?
That's really tough, because a lot of them that I don't even remember.
Well, I mean, I guess, like out of last, like, year, like, Rap Bag and stuff.
Out of the last year, or, like, the last couple of years? Because, like, if you're thinking, like, stuff that, like, people have heard in the community that they would know about, I think it would have to be one of the ones I'm most proud of is the By the Farm soundtrack, but that's mostly just because it reached a wide audience, and I think a lot of people just kind of thought it was generic music, which is, like, that might seem like a bad thing, but I'm kind of glad of that, just because that means that I did my job of, like, making a sort of generic, sort of spooky orchestra music.
Yeah. I mean, I'm gonna go back and watch that and just, like, listen to the music, because, like, I didn't even know you did that until, like, a little while back.
I do all the music, like, I think I'm mostly live action scenes, from my recollection. That's one that I'm really proud of. The bear theme that I did for you, and, like, all the subsequent versions I've done in the past. that Wimpy Kid did, I'm really proud of, just because it feels really energetic and...
Yeah. Oh, I mean, I'll link like that or your SoundCloud down in the description when I get around to doing that.
Uploaded anything on SoundCloud recently. Maybe I'll do that some of that tonight. But maybe I'll do it on Audius. Who knows? I'll send you links.
We'll see.
I've got a lot of really good music coming up in the future. There was going to be a Christmas special last year that I didn't have enough time. But I'm gonna keep workshopping it and release it this year, I think.
Yeah, no, I've seen from the little stuff that I've seen, it is pretty nice.
Fun. I might even redo the score in it, maybe even reshoot it, just because I want to keep advancing my visuals as I go along. And plus, now that I have a bunch more characters and I'm getting more stuff to make, I can just make it look a little better.
Yeah.
I'm very focused on trying to make my videos as good looking as possible. And just as unique as possible as well, which is music. Music is part of that. So when Out of Puff eventually comes out, I'm doing a full score for that one as well, which is really cool. And I think there's some, at least the first theme in that, I'm really pleased with right now because it feels very classic-esque. I'm trying to think about other songs that I've done that I'm pretty proud of. There's a lot of stuff. There's a couple things on my SoundCloud. I think there's one like Simply Thomas thing that's pretty cool on there that I like.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm pretty sure I listened to that. It's pretty nice. It's pretty fun.
Yeah, that one's one that I kind of... Sometimes I'll just listen to that just when I'm, like, driving. Which sounds kind of self-indulgent, but, like, I need something to listen to when I drive.
I mean, if it sounds good, then it sounds good. I mean, it shouldn't really matter, like, if you made it or not.
Yeah.
For a bit.
That's kind of it, though. I can't really think of anything else.
It's all good there. And this is the last individualized for like the big old wrap up, but out of like all your models, HO or Wind Railway, what was your favorite to make? Like not what's your favorite one, but like if you could like what was the one that had the most fun like cooking up?
Okay, that's really tough. I think there's probably a couple for each like Wooden Railway and Bachman. So I think my favorite one in Wooden Railway to make was definitely Tornado. And it sucks because Tornado is in a state of disrepair right now. The dome cracked and I gotta make some new ones. I might do that tonight. I need something to do. I don't know. My friend wanted me to come over and smoke weed, but like I'd rather just model. So what I'll do is I'll probably work on Tornado tonight because I know somebody wants Tornado. I think Henry does.
I can see that's on Henry's stuff.
The Tornado was fun because that was the first one I ever airbrushed, and also that was the first one I ever ordered 3D parts for.
Oh, yeah. Did you get those, the smoke box off of
Shapeways? Yeah, the smoke box with the deflectors. That was the first thing I ever ordered from, like, Shapeways, besides, like, Thomas Faces or whatever. I don't really count.
Yeah.
Like that's a custom thing, I guess, but it's not like it's a part for, like, an engine.
Yeah.
And I'm still really proud of how Tornado looks just because of its sort of gloss coat and the color I picked for it. And it's my favorite steam engine, so I'm really proud of how that one turned out.
Nice.
I'm also pretty proud of the Coldy Fell engines I made, even though I've never shown them off on YouTube. I think they look pretty good. Maybe I'll make a video on them now that I've said it. Now I've got an obligation to.
There's the tease, boys.
Yeah, no, they're all different colors and their faces are gray, so pure, so I'm going to be mad, but I think they look pretty cool.
Yeah, no, they do.
And that's
the
one thing, if I ever go back to Wooden Railway, the first thing I'm doing is getting those Coldy Fell engines some use in something. Because I don't really want to do Coldy Fell and N scale, I don't have the money for that. But I could probably crank out some Wooden Railway stuff with them.
Yeah, that'd be funny.
In Bachman, that's really tough, because I can't really say any of them were fun to make. They've all had their own trials. Like Henry especially, his paint was a real fickle pain in the ass. But I love how he turned out. Like he looks really good. Like I'm looking at him right now. He looks really fun.
He's saying hello.
Wilbert was a fun one to do just because it was kind of fun to stylize this realistic engine I bought and make it look like a sort of classic series color scheme and like design.
Yeah.
But I think my favorite one was Thomas just because he was my first one. And he's definitely getting redone once I eventually, hopefully, get some parts I ordered. Some brass couplings and buffers that I bought. Like, once I get those parts, he's definitely getting redone.
Change the location of the computer, guys. It's okay. Ronnie.
Yeah.
Dude, promote yourself right now. Say
okay,
thanks
so
to the whole
I've
press.
I've got a channel, I've got a SoundCloud, I've got a Twitter. Don't follow me on Twitter. The guy from Over the Hedge follows me on Twitter. I've got an Audius, but I never use it. I've got an Instagram, but I post pictures of me, so don't look at it. What do I do? I'm going to do a bunch of Bachman videos. I got Out of Puff coming soon. So get ready for it. Christmas time. You've got time to wait. Well, I'm going to help Jake out with videos. I'm going to help Ty out with videos. I'm going to help Henry out with videos. I'm going to tell Train's account. It's going to be good. We like the little Scaloony squad. We have a ton of cool stuff. We're all working together. It's really cool. It's like synergy. It's kick ass.
It's whipping up kitchen like a stir fry, you know?
William Politeski messaged me like 2 days ago saying, you want to do some music for me? And I was like, sure. And then I went home after work and I slept. I need to text him back and ask what he needs. But I want to really get back into like doing stuff for the larger community again. I haven't done that in a while. If
sorry to say it, but in this little bit, Ronnie's audio cut out and so did mine. But this has been the first episode of Ty Talks. Hope you all enjoyed, and I'll be seeing you later. Goodbye.